Hello YouTubers. I'm going to throw in this very quick insert because I thought this might fascinate or at least provide some feedback for some people who are asking a little question about the Unity UT81B. The question that was asked was, can you use the kind of oscilloscope function on it to scope current? And I was actually just setting up, there's a couple of things I was doing out here. For one, I'm setting up to do a video on how to use an oscilloscope. So that hopefully will be posted in the future. I was able to teach myself a few things out here while I was preparing for that. Two, it was partly to test that whole thing about the current measurement as a representation on the Unity. Well, I was jumping in with my clock project, the solar powered clock project, where I was measuring the current or the current consumption. So I thought I'd just connect it up, measure the current, and see if it could be represented as a signal on the scope. So I'll take you in for a quick closer look, and then I say in the future there's a few things which are being shown here which will happen in more detail in future videos. The one is obviously the clock, back to this how to solar power my clock, a tear down and another in-depth look at the Unity 81B, and then how to use an oscilloscope. Okay, so here we go. I've got the clock ticking away over there. I have my variable power supply supplying the voltage to the clock, which is obviously going through the Unity scope meter. And I've got it set to kind of microamps. And I'll just draw you in to have a look. And there you go. I've got the trigger set, so that we've got a nice... It catches the waveform each time the clock ticks, and there you go. That is, as opposed to normally what you'd see on an oscilloscope, a voltage representation over time. This is current over time, and that's capturing the current kind of peak signal, which is happening every time the clock ticks, in essence. We can try and change the time base for that. There you go. Sometimes the trigger isn't quite catching that, but you can see I've kind of in essence changed the time base, so we go in a little bit closer. Let's just do it a little more closer. And here this little scope obviously on this doesn't capture as nicely as a proper oscilloscope. But we'll cover all these bits and pieces off once I get into the how to use an oscilloscope. So there we go. Okay, hope you found that of interest. I say, if you do find these bits and pieces of interest, then please do subscribe to the videos. And if you gain any value, please give them a thumbs up. Thanks very much.